Oh, you're welcome this evening again. I know you have been waiting. Hallelujah. Without wasting time, you know, okay, let me introduce. This is Online Healing Crusade. For people who are coming on the first time, maybe you are just fiddling with your phone and then you are saying, what's this? This Online Healing Crusade takes place like this every day, 6 p.m. GMT plus one. So tomorrow you are invited. We are expecting to see you. I want to tell you that the Lord is here and the Lord is visiting people. God has something to do in your life and God has a word for you. Without wasting time, let's welcome the servants of the Lord. He's the servant of the Lord that God has commissioned to preach the gospel of the Lord Jesus. And I tell you, the word of the Lord is with him. Stay tuned and be connected. Join me to welcome the servants of the Lord, Evangelist Louis Olufemi Ogunlari. God bless you.
Praise the living Jesus. Father, we thank you again for another opportunity to minister your word. And we thank you for what you have been doing through this program and this platform. We ask that you take us from the letter of the word into the spirit in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Matthew chapter 12, where's where we're going again today. Matthew chapter 12, we're reading from verse 14 all to verse 21. From verse 14 up to verse 21. Then the Pharisees went out and held a council against him, how they might destroy him. But when Jesus knew it, he withdrew himself from thence. And great multitude followed him, and he healed them all, and charged them that they should not make him known, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, Behold, my servant, whom I have chosen, my beloved, in whom my soul is well pleased. I will put my spirit upon him, and he shall show judgment to the Gentiles. He shall not strive nor cry, neither shall any man hear his voice in the streets. A bruised reed shall he not break, and smoking flax shall he not quench, till he send forth judgment into victory. And in his name shall the Gentiles trust.
Tonight, like we read the other time, we want to read from the Passion. Immediately the Pharisees went out and started to scheme about how they would do away with him. Now, do away with Jesus. Then Jesus knew what they were thinking, so he learned by another way. Massive crowds followed him from there, and he healed all who were sick. However, he sternly warned them not to tell others or disclose his real identity in order to fulfill the prophecy of Isaiah. Take a careful look at my servant, my chosen one. I love him dearly and I find all my delight in him. And I will breathe my spirit upon him and he will decree justice to the nations. He will not quarrel or be found yelling in public. He won't brush aside the bruised and broken. He will be gentle with the weak and feeble. Okay? Until his victory releases justice. And the fame of his name will bear hope among the people. The islands will wait for his teaching. That's what that means. Okay? When the Bible says he will be gentle with the weak, it means a bruised reed he will not break, and a smoldering wick he will not extinguish. This means that he will not fail or be discouraged in his assignment. Alright, now, what I want to bring up to us today, I will divide it into some sessions. The first is, let's look at the reaction of these Pharisees. Bible says, Pharisees went out and they held a council together, a meeting against Jesus, how they will destroy him. Is it possible for people to be planning against a pastor, planning against a man of God, planning against ministers of the gospel in order to look for how they can destroy him? That's another powerful sentence. How can you be thinking of how to destroy Jesus? So there are people that are anti-Christ. There are people that are against Jesus. There are people that are anti-anointing. There are people that are against the anointed. It's not everybody that loves you. It's not everybody that wish you well, but they can't stop you. Whether you don't like me or not, you can't stop me. Okay, look at verse 15. When Jesus knew it, he withdrew himself. himself from thence. I learned something there. That except God tells you to go and face a mob, don't go and face them. I learned something there. If people are against you somewhere, the Bible did not say because of that, go and start a riot against them. Bring a placard. Why are you against me? Why don't you know that God sent me and things like that? Are you getting what I'm saying? They are planning to arrest Jesus, and the Bible says he withdrew and took another way. So it means that Jesus will not naturally go and fight anybody for whatever reason. Praise God. I want to read that to you, Matthew 12, verse 15. Jesus from the Passion. Jesus knew what they were thinking. So he left by another way. That is a way that people know that he used to pass, which they are planning with their own scheme, that if he passed through this place, he always go through that road, then he will eventually arrive there. Let's find a way to arrest him and then take him to the government and start looking for how to, you know, crucify him. But we knew it was not yet time to do that. So he went through another way. Wow. So there may be a right way, but there will be another way. There may be your usual route, there will be another route. Are you getting what I'm saying? You don't expose yourself to danger. Except God says, go and face them, I will defend you. They are looking for him, and he knew they want to destroy him, and he knew it was not yet time for him to die, so he looked for another way. Is it that Jesus is running away from man? No. At another time, they arrest him, he will disappear in their midst. Maybe the Holy Ghost tell him, go well, you finish your message. I know they are around, they want to arrest you, but finish your message. When you finish, let them do whatever they do, I know what I'll do. But this other one, why they were planning, God told them, don't go to that place, they are planning to arrest you, they are, go through another road. And he obeyed. I always read in between the lines. That means the best way, our best defense in life, is to follow the Holy Spirit. Don't always have a calculated way of doing things. Don't be strict with your rules of life. Don't be saying that nobody can do this, anything cannot happen, this one cannot happen. It's just like you want to travel and the Holy Spirit tells you not to travel, or you have a feeling in your spirit that this journey is not going to be a nice journey, something else can happen. Why don't you withdraw about the journey and still be praying for some time? Are you getting what I'm saying? If you lose an appointment, you will not lose your assignment. May I repeat that for you? If you lose your appointment with somebody, I have given my word that I'm coming by 4 p.m., so I must be there. So I must start the journey. It's a 3 hours journey to get to the place. So 1 o'clock, I'm already driving to the place seriously, so I can make my appointment for 4 o'clock. But around 12, my spirit started feeling I shouldn't travel. And I made that promise maybe 2 or 3 days ago. I didn't have that feeling then. But now to the time to start traveling, my spirit is saying, don't go that way. But I've given them my word. Holy Ghost will keep quiet because it's a still small voice, not an arguing voice. After some time, when you yourself you cool down, you will rise up again. Don't go that way. But I've given my word. I mean, a man must stand by his word. A man can die by his word. If you are trying to stand by your word, you can die by your word. But Jesus Christ knew they were planning to arrest him. And the Bible said, he got away through another way, not through the way they were waiting for him to arrest him. I remember many years ago, a testimony from my father and the Lord, somebody who was a member of the church, worked with one of the newspaper in our country, Sketch, in those days. And then they have given a report, national news or something, and it has come out in their paper, and maybe it's affecting the government. They don't like that news, so they have made up their mind from government that they are coming to come and risk all of them that are in the working room of that newspaper company Sketch in those days. And nobody knew they were coming. They came with armored tank as if something serious in Black Maria, not armored tank, Black Town. They just risk all of them and drop them inside and take them away. And people will not know what happened to them. But this one, who is led by the Spirit, shortly before they came, God told them, leave all that you are doing on your table, right? Take your bag, go out through the back door. And then he went out. He said, it's not your time for a break. Take your vehicle, go home. Are you hearing what I'm saying? God told him, take your vehicle. You're already outside now. Take your vehicle, just go home. He obeyed. But he knew he was going to be in trouble tomorrow to face Queen. Why did he leave the office like that? We saw everything on your table. I see you are still coming back. What happened? But there was no query. You know what happened? Everybody inside the office has been taken away. They were risking a few minutes. If he had gone through the door, he would have been part of it that would be arrested. But God said, take exit through the back door. And then when he got outside through the back door, he said, ah, it's not yet break. Why am I outside? So take a vehicle, get out, go to your house. So the next day he was having, in fact, the evening news of that day, it came out that all the people in the office have been winked away. He would have been one of them. Are you getting what I'm saying? So what am I saying? Jesus Christ knew they were about to arrest him, but the Bible said he went away through another way. So you need sensitivity more than activity. Let me think of activity and then lose your sensitivity. Even when we are on duty for God, not duty for a natural person, we are working an office. In the office is not a natural office, it's a spiritual office. You are in the office of a great man of God or whatever. You are in a ministry that is a worldwide ministry. That notwithstanding, obey the Holy Ghost. He's our surest help and guide now in this world. We don't have any other person that can protect us more than him. He's our own security guard. It's our defense. It's our protection. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So Jesus Christ did that, and I want us to learn that as part of our lesson for today. So when Jesus has withdrew himself to another way, great multitude followed him to where he went, and he healed them all. Hallelujah. I like that. He went out, but great multitude still followed him to where he went out to. Are you getting that? Let me read it from the Passion. So Jesus knew what they were thinking, so he led by another way. Massive crowds followed him from there, and he healed all who were sick among them. So that means, leaving where he was going before to go to another way did not disturb his healing anointing. It did not disturb the program of God. More people see God's healed where he went to. So since you are allowed to heal the sick and raise the dead and cast out devil and all that, as long as you are still doing it, doesn't matter whether you change the venue or not. You remember when he was sending out the disciples, so then when you are going, when you get to a place and they welcome you, preach the gospel. If they don't welcome you, brush your sandal and then move to another place. He didn't say no, bring out a placard. Tell them, we no go green, oh, we no go green. He didn't say you should do that. So where they don't accept you, walk away to another place, they will accept you. So here, Pharisees of this town, we are planning to arrest him. He moved to somewhere else. Wherever he moved to, the Bible says that the people were there in great multitude. There is multitude, there is great multitude. This is crowd, massive crowd, followed him from there. And he healed all who were sick. KJP said, he healed them all. It means even the miracle that happened here was more than some places that he has been before. Because here they didn't say he healed one blind man or he healed one lame man. He healed them all. It means there was nobody sick that day that was not healed. Praise God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? That was the time I was planning a crusade in India many years back. And I had a lot of difficulty in Nigeria getting a visa to travel. And then I went to Lagos. From Lagos, I went again to Abuja. Having different kind of issues with the embassy. Finally, after a long pursuit, whatever, we found our way to India. And when I got there, I'd been there a year before that time. Going from one village to the other. I didn't know that they have changed the plan. It's not village now. It was a big city crusade that they did. And you know what I'm saying? And over there, because they've been planning the program ahead of time, so the devil was only trying to block me from getting there. But that's the key, man. If the man gets there, something is going to happen. Don't let him get there. So all the disturbances I was getting was the devil trying to stop me here. If they stopped me in Lagos, I went to Abuja. If they stopped me there, I went here. But eventually, I got it from Abuja and I traveled out. That was one of my best crusades ever. In the attendance, in the number of things that God did there, wow. and about 4 or 5 of my people, some were already waiting for me in the country, some traveled with me from Nigeria. We had about 5 hands to use, laying hands on the sick and ministering, Holy Ghost baptism, everything. Some I'll be inside praying, ready for evening, my pastors and that the ministry will go to different places to go and preach in different churches, just to allow them that the great man of God is already around. Let's call, let's make sure we meet together in the evening to go. If they were combing the land, all throughout what was going on in my heart, this was what the devil saw, that he was trying to block me from coming here. So the devil knew that something is about to break loose about the life of Jesus Christ here. Then he has taken the Pharisees to go and arrest him. So that arrest will disturb his mind or whatever, so he will be able to do what God wants to do next. But the Holy Ghost now gave him the wisdom. Don't go where you'll be arrested. Go to another way. And when you go to another way, you got out to another way, where you went, people were massively crowded, waiting for the ministry of the Lord Jesus Christ. And that was where the anointing came out more, stronger, that he now healed them all. You know what it means to heal them all? Have you seen a great crusade where hundreds of thousands of people are there? You know how many people will be sick in a place where you have 100,000 congregation who come to come and attend the crusade? You could have many thousands of sick people, sick with different kinds of sicknesses. But for God to say he healed all of them, that means it's not just gift of healing that came that day. What came that day was the Lord the healer, the healing anointing, the anointing, the anointed. That one has no unit, no boundary. When the Lord come like that, it's not all the time it does that. But once in a while, when the Lord come like that, the healing anointing will engulf the whole place. Nobody will go without the visible healing. I remember many years ago in Nigeria here, one of the great men of God has gone to be with the Lord now, Prophet Obadiah, was ministering in Tafa Balewa Square in Lagos, race course. Open air crusade. He's been doing first day, second day, whatever. But one of the days, maybe the last day, the man speak our local language, shouted in the local language. What was he saying? The one that sent me has just come in now. And when he said that, the anointing came down. Healing was just happening. Every kind of healing was happening. Every kind of healing was happening. But day one, it was not like that. Day two, it was not like that. That's the last day. But he knew in his way that there is something that descended of this meeting tonight. He that sent me, he has just come in. Praise God. And when he comes in, he doesn't leave anybody. Peter was in the prison. People prayed for him. He was delivered from the prison. Paul and Silas were in the prison. Nobody prayed for them. But they themselves, they did prayer and praise worship by themselves. And the Bible says the presence of the Lord came inside the prison. But inside the prison, he did not just deliver Paul and Silas. Everybody in chains, their chains broke up. Everybody in bondage, their bondage were loose. There's a difference between one man was healed and the rest are still there, and when all were healed. In this case, all were loosed from chains. And you tell me that all of them if they were born again? I don't think so. Are there armed robbers there? Well, yeah. Are there no rapists there? Oh, much more. Are there arsonists there? Oh, plenty. Are there people who are trying to wage war against the government? Oh, they plenty. So why would God deliver all of them? Because he came that day to heal all, respective of their level. Are you hearing what I'm saying? There's no limit to what God can do, my brother. I want to pray with you today. I don't want you to have any fear in your heart that there's one sickness bigger than God, that there's something that's in your body that God cannot heal you. It doesn't matter the problem of the case. The healing anointing is able to deal with every problem of man. The presence of God is able to deal with every every problem of man. Are you hearing what I'm saying? The anointing is what destroys yokes in people's lives. Are you hearing me? I've ministered in different kind of places and I've seen different kind of things before, my brother. And I believe nothing can hold God down. No limit, no boundary. The power of God has no limit, has no boundary. Let me give you one scripture and then I pray. Job 42. Job 42. Verse 2. I know that thou can do everything, and that no thought can be withholding from thee. I know that thou can do what? All things and everything, and no thoughts can be withholding from thee. You know what that means? Nobody can stop God when God is ready to work. No thought of God can be withholden by somebody. There is a level that we pray and we say, oh, the devil did not allow the prayer to be answered. Maybe there's one demon around, that's why the prayer is not answered. If God is ready to answer prayer, all the demons of the world can stop him. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Jesus got to a place, he wanted to pray for a man, and he told the man, are you ready to be made whole? The man said, actually, I've been here for a long time, and then there's nobody to put me to the water. And I said, are you ready to be made whole? So you look at that man, he doesn't have an altar of faith. Yet, Jesus Christ did not heal any of that person that they accept that man. And in the midst of all kind of sicknesses that were there, he didn't call all of them for healing. He just went to that man and talked to the man until he ministered to the man, and the man stood there 38 years he had been sick. Maybe the oldest or the sickest, and do not to the grammar. Among everybody there, long-standing sickness, longest, 38 years. Even Jesus Christ has been living in this world for 38 years, so he has been sick, he has been very of them. So you have to wait till when Jesus Christ will be 13 years for Jesus to start ministry, and then for Jesus to please come to Bethsaida so that I can come and meet him there. 38 years. But that is my point. It's not the faith of the man that he knows. It's the supernatural presence of God, the magnanimity of God, the sovereignty of God. So rise up, take your bed and go home. And somebody could not work for 38 years today. You understand what I'm saying? I've seen God work. So I know that nothing can hold God from working when he's ready to work. And today he's ready to work. Praise God. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, everyone hearing the sound of my voice today, that they have been listening to this word, and for one reason or the other, they need supernatural intervention in their life. First, I'm going to pray for you. Are you born again? If you are not, that will hinder the flow of the supernatural in your direction. So place your hand on your chest and let me lead you into Christ. Say the following words after me. Lord Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. You died on the cross of Calvary for me. Today I ask that you wash me from my sins with your blood and write my name in the book of life and give me a new beginning. Your word say, any man that come to you, you will no wise cast them out. So I know you won't cast me out, you rather take me in. But I ask that you give me a new beginning and make me a member of the family of God today. I know you hear me. In Jesus' name, I pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, everyone hearing the sound of my voice that does pray that prayer, I ask that they be established in your kingdom from this hour in the name of Jesus. And not only that, if you know you have taken that prayer and your life is changed in this moment and this hour, write to us or communicate with us whichever way you can, and I'm going to send you a book. Request for our book. I have a book I've written for young people who have just gotten born again, a new Christian, on how to help them in their Christian life. I'll send it to you free from anywhere you are calling from the world. That's one. Number two, we talk about healing today and the supernatural power of God healing the people. Whatever sickness is on your body, can you lay your hand where the sickness is? I want to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke spirit of sickness, disease, and infirmity. In the name of Jesus, be healed from the top of your head to the sole of your feet in the name of Jesus. Every spirit that is supervising sickness, I command you, use your grip and use your hold on their life right now. In the name of Jesus. Not only that, what is it you couldn't do before? Say the sickness came on your body. Stand up now, begin to do them. In the name of Jesus. You couldn't move your hand, move them. You couldn't move your leg, move them. You couldn't stand up, roll away from that bed. Come on. The spirit of the Lord is upon you. The healing anointing is working upon you right now. In the name of Jesus. We're whatever you couldn't do before, you find out the ability of God is come upon you. The power of God is the ability of God. And it's upon you to change the situation. I say, I watch over my word to perform it. When I say, rise up, the power of God will make you to be able to rise up. When I say, walk, the power of God will make you to be able to walk. You take a step of faith, you see that the supernatural has caught up with you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, I pray. Until tomorrow, be healthy, wealthy, and strong. God bless you.